football!
Woo! It's almost here. So excited. Barkley, name co. Fantasy 2019 wide receiver rankings. But first,
there we go.
How can we do FanDuel? How can we make money? Money, 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 money.
FanDuel Sportsbook. It's a real thing now. You can make bets on your phone, on your couch, on Sunday. What's not to like about that? There's 10 states that offer it right now. Nevada, Delaware, New Jersey, Mississippi, West Virginia, New Mexico, Pennsylvania, Rhode Island, Arkansas, and New York. And there's more coming. If you're in one of those states, click on the link in the description. Sign up. Deposit some money. It helps us out. Which, why wouldn't you want to do that?
Yeah, help out your buddies.
So check that out. Also, don't forget about our draft guide, our little cheat sheet we got going on. Click on the link in the description for that as well. It's free.
Free. Tier one. Let's put it this way. They're all beasts, right? Hopkins, Adams, Thomas. I love every single one of them. They're all going to get over 100 catches this year. They're all going to be about 1,400 yards. They all could get double-digit touchdowns. They're all really, really good.
Tier two, they're all really, really good too.
Not as good as my tier.
They aren't as good as your tier, but there's still some big names. Odell Beckham, it's weird to say this, that he goes to the Browns and he's upgrading teams.
Ooh.
So that's just,
Giants fans, how do you feel about Mr. Barkley now?
But, I mean, you got to feel like going to the Browns is an upgrade situation for him. Going to, from Eli to Mayfield, he's got some guys to take some pressure off him with Landry. And, you know, it's just that offense just seems like they have some pieces. It's interesting. Odell Beckham, if he can stay healthy, should have a great year. Juju Smith, he's the guy now. Antonio Brown's gone. You know, so that means Juju's going to be getting the attention. It's a little scary, but I don't think it's too scary, obviously, because we have him at six. He should have another a monster season. Great season for him last year. We are liking some Juju.
As we go into tier three, I just want to first talk about, like, kind of an old reference, but a Rodney Dangerfield wide receivers. Mr. Adam Thielen.
No respect.
No respect ever for this guy. You know who's going to draft this guy? Every single person that had him last year. Because he was a beast, and if you owned him, you had a 33% chance, apparently, of winning the championship, because out of all the championships, 33% of those teams own Thielen. He was a monster last year, could be great again, and my personal favorite in this tier, Mr. Keenan Allen, finally stayed healthy. When he's healthy, he is a monster. Rivers loves him. He's a target monster. You know how I feel about him. I'm willing to double down that he stays healthy again, gets all those targets, and I love where you can get him on draft day because of that.
Thielen did trail off a little bit towards the end of last year when they went a little run.
That's why we got him ranked as such. I don't think he's going to repeat. But
still a big fan. He does get no respect.
He's going to slip in drafts. He's the guy that slips.
Tyreek Hill, as we're shooting, we have not heard the official what's going to happen. Is it going to be 4 games, 6 games, 8 games? Who knows? We're ranking him right here, assuming he gets 4 games. You know, we think that's the appropriate downgrade because he'd be up there in tier one, you know, if he wasn't getting suspended. So we'll wait and see what happens and then reassess on where his draft value should be. And then Julian Edelman, you know, we've seen him ranked higher than this. We have him at 17. You know, with Gronk being gone, or maybe being gone, it seems like, you know, there's going to be more targets going to Edelman, but it just, they did draft Harry, and it's just, Edelman's had some injury stuff. It's just hard to get super, super excited about him, but he's still a solid wide receiver team.
So going to tier five, man, we're talking about, I love Edelman, these are my guys. You know who else I love? I've always loved Lockett, and he finally did what he thought he could do last year. You know, he had 10 touchdowns. The fact he had 965 yards and not 1,000, I feel like is making him go down. It's some weird thing, but think about it. Basically 1,000 yards, 10 touchdowns. It's going to be the number one guy again for Russell Wilson. Look to see where he's going on draft day for yourself. And then Mr. Jarvis Landry. Odell going there, we believe, helps him way more than it hurts him. Sure, there's less targets to go around, but Landry's the slot guy. You know, he's the possession guy. And I think with the safeties having to play back with Odell, it's going to do nothing but help him.
Tyler Boyd, I want to talk about.
Oh, Boyd.
He had some great games last year. You know, Green missed some time, and that just seems to be a theme these days with Green with staying healthy. And we might be seeing a changing of the guard out there in Cincinnati in terms of, you know, who the true number one wide receiver is going to be in the future. You know, if Green's healthy, I still think he's the guy. But Boyd has that type of potential, that type of upside. We like him. in the middle rounds. And another guy I really like is Robbie Anderson. You know, I see a lot of T.Y. Hilton in him. You know, he's not just a deep threat guy. He can do it all. And with having Bell out there, having other weapons on that offense to just kind of take some pressure off some of the other guys, Darnold being one more year experienced, and just look at Robbie Anderson's game log down the stretch. It was impressive. I don't know. I'm just saying there's some upside
there. Do you see T.Y. because of my irrational hate that I had for T.Y. and now Robbie?
They're kind of the same size, and people kind of put them in the, oh, they're just deep threat category, but they're really not. They can do more things. So I just, and I think he could be an all-around good receiver. So we'll see.
All right, tier seven, a guy that we have hated on. He was on our bus list last year. We've always hated him. Corey Davis.
He might actually be a value.
Hate. But whenever they zig, smack talk zags. Do we have him on our sleeper list?
It's not official.
Not official? Hey, he might be. So this is a guy that we've hated forever, and he's never really performed. We've always been right. Might be time. Might be time based on draft day value where you can actually get him. We kind of like Corey Davis. You know, he had almost 900 yards last year, only four touches. I wouldn't be shocked if those numbers go up, especially the touchdown total.
Post-hype sleeper. Tier 8, Geronimo Allison for Green Bay. This is interesting. If he ends up locking up that wide receiver 2 position, it could be a nice spot for him. You know, they're already looking at, you know, throwing the ball more this year, getting back to that kind of high-powered passing offense. Allison has shown us some, you know, some little snippets here and there of some potential. We think this is a guy that, you know, just grabbing the later rounds, guy that has a nice upside.
Tier 9, talking about Sammy Watkins. He's not good. I don't care what anyone says. I don't think he's good. And with Hill being out, I see people being like, oh, this is the guy to grab. He's going to do exactly what he did. No chance. They're totally different players. Sammy also has that. He was drafted in the first round. He was supposed to be great on the Bills. Never was. Again, he's going to get a little more targets until Hill comes back. But we have him ranked here for a reason.
Next, I want to talk about Gabriel with the Bears. We've seen this guy ranked so low, and I get it. He's not necessarily that guy that's going to be that all-around receiver that's going to get you, you know, 100 catches, 1,200 yards, double-digit touchdowns. But I'm kind of comparing people here. I kind of see a little bit of Lockett in him in terms of what he could be for that Bears team. I mean, he did have 67 catches last year. They involve him in the rushing game a little bit. They're going to find creative ways to get him involved. He's just a good football player. And I don't think people should forget about him on draft day because I don't necessarily know if we've seen his ceiling yet. And that Bears offense, I think, is headed in the right direction.
Just had a premonition. Watkins is going to have a big week one. Trade him immediately after. Telling him, calling it right now.
All right.
Tier 11, James Washington, Pittsburgh. He said about Juju, Brown is gone. Washington's probably going to step in as the number two. He's obviously got, you know, he can be a deep threat. The Steelers' offense is a high-power offense. It's going to look very different this year than it was 2 years ago, but still, they're going to move the ball up and down the field.
And my favorite late-round sleeper, Andy Isabella, with the Cardinals. Couple of problems. He's got Larry Fitz there. He's got Kirk there. He's kind of the slot guy. We'll see where he fits in, if he can get out on the field. But I'm telling you, this guy has some potential of being a nice PPR guy. Look at his college stats. The guy was a stud in college. He was the first rookie that they took, wide receiver that they took this year for Arizona. I think he's the guy to own in terms of just real deep dynasty keeper type leagues. He's going to be fun. I can see him maybe being a Cooper Kupp kind of guy. These comparisons.
Yeah, you're doing comps left and right.
Left and right.
All about the comps, eh? Money throw.
That was pretty good.
That was a money throw. I don't know if it came up, but
Andy Isabella told
you it was going to be in our QB video that it'd be good.
Andy Isabella.
That is Dustin's new guy.
Deep sleep.
Until I steal him away.
Deep sleeper. Check out all our stuff. FanDuel. Get on
cheat sheet. Subscribe. Give us a like. Give us some love. Any comments, we'll try to answer as well.